Good morning. This is All India Radio Kohima. The morning news read by Jonas Yantan. Prime Minister Narendra Modi said democracy in India has always been a means of resolving differences along with governance. He said different views and different perspectives always empower a vibrant democracy. Modi said policies and politics may vary, but government is for the service of public and there should be no differences in this ultimate goal. He said every delegate who reaches Parliament is accountable, and this accountability is also towards the public and to the Constitution. The Prime Minister urged the people to take the pledge to keep India first, to worship only the progress of India and the development of India. Every decision should increase the strength of the country and that the country's interest is paramount. He asked everyone to take the pledge that there will be no greater interest for them than national interest. He asked people to pledge that their concern for the country will be more than their own personal concerns and nothing will be more important to them than unity and integrity of the country. Two houses were gutted at Miralitsa Colony in Kohima last night. In the fire, a private house was razed to the ground and a government quarter was partially gutted. However, no casualty was reported from the incident. The fire department, on receiving information about the news, rushed fire tenders to the spot and brought the fire under control. Residents of the colony also helped in dosing off the fire. Police said gas leakage is suspected to be the cause of the fire. Further investigation is on to determine the exact cause of fire and the extent of damage. Advisor Fisheries and Aquatic Resources El Kamo inaugurated Panso Public Ground yesterday. The advisor also donated an ambulance towards PHC Panso, which was handed over through Patso Area GP's Union. Meanwhile, NST Division Manager Twensang Andrew P. Tikir inaugurated NST Staff Quarter cum Booking Counter at Panso. Advisor Kumo was accompanied by SP Noklag, ESC Panso, PDO Panso, MO Noklag, officials and party workers. Pandari Additional Deputy Commissioner ADC in an order directed that prior permission should be taken for all social and religious gatherings for active monitoring and enforcement of standing SOP on COVID-19. The order further directed the STPO and the officers in charge of Pandari Police Station to impose a fine of 100 rupees on those who are caught without using face masks in public places. Further, church leaders, public leaders and school authorities have been directed to strictly adhere to the SOP. Public transport, including taxis, has also been directed not to carry above 50% of passenger capacity. Centre has said the farm's reforms have been brought forth, keeping in mind the best interest of the farmers. Addressing the media in New Delhi yesterday, Agriculture Minister Narendra Singh Tomar said the government wanted to liberate the farmers from the shackles of mandi so that they could sell their produce anywhere to anyone at his own price outside the purview of mandi. He said government expressed that it is ready for open-minded discussions on provisions they have objections against. He said centre tried to explain to the farmers that laws do not affect APMCs or MSP. He said that they send proposals to allay concerns over MSP and APMCs, but farmers' leaders rejected those. The minister said the government kept waiting for suggestions from farmers' leaders to address their concerns, but they are stuck on repeal of laws. Minister of State for Defence Sripad Naik said the media has an important role in dealing with anti-India forces. He said it is the responsibility of all, including the media persons, to ensure that media is not misused by anti-India forces against the country. He was speaking at a valedictory function of a media communication course organised by the Indian Institute of Mass Communication for Defence Personnel. And as the nation fights COVID-19 pandemic, let us all remember to stay safe and protected by following these three simple steps. Wear a face mask, wash hands frequently with soap and water, or use hand sanitizer and follow social distancing. With that, we come to the end of the morning news. Have a nice day.